The capitalist system that we all have grown up in is one that puts itself forward as being natural, inevitable, healthy, useful. So that Adam Smith's hidden hand that supposedly allows for everybody's greed to somehow combine into the common good has had for many people's lives a very, very different actual effect. We're again locked into situations where privileged people with access to education, access to other things, will tell you is their virtuous utilization of these things they have access to that have elevated them to where they are, and that other people could do the very same thing, and to the extent that they're not, this really shows that something's wrong with them, but we can eke out a little charity to them to make sure that they're okay, or maybe give them some basic income, but trying to solve at a level of consumption a problem that was created at the level of production by people not having the opportunity to be fully productive, and we try to change that by giving them the tokens of consumption so that they can stay alive. And that's insufficient, and that won't change the world. In order to do better than we're doing now, we have to develop an analytical framework for understanding how the situation that we're in became what it is and what a path out of it is. And so economic democracy would be that the people themselves would be the determiners of the economies in their communities so that we create good jobs. We create opportunities for young people to learn and prepare for the future. We create the housing that we need of the quality that we wanted to live in it. We try to make sure that kind of speculative activity and land and housing doesn't damage our ability to continue to live in the neighborhoods that we have grown up and been a part of. So these are the kinds of things that economic democracy would afford an opportunity for people to themselves be a part of constructing the solutions, the creative solutions that need to be created.